when I met him and I see him, I was like, what if I look like that when I get older?
He looks like me when I was little. So it was just cool, like almost seeing your younger self and just thinking about what was possible.
We talk about things that's just going on in our life. Like, feels like Eric is part of my family.
And growing up, there weren't really people in my life that I could identify as queer in the media or that I knew personally. To like intentionally form that relationship can be very powerful, I think, for both of us.
I thought it sounded completely out of my comfort zone, which is part of the reason why I wanted to do it, something different. So knowing that I'm a positive role model for my little, I feel like it means a lot more than I expected it to.
Cheryl's like a big sister to me. I don't really like talk to people a lot. I keep to myself. She's like a friend that like I never had before.
You know, I hear people say if you can see it, you can be it, right? Representation matters because we're not used to always seeing people like us do certain things. They just need that quality time, those words of affirmation to have an example and to know like I can make it.
So to have representation, especially a real life person in their life who can show them what their potential is, I think that's really powerful. And I wish I had had that when I was a kid. And so I'm really excited to be able to do that with the Big Pride program.
Since I've known Eric, I've felt more comfortable in my own skin.
Cheryl made it possible for me to think I could make it out of college and get a good life and a good job. I think it's because of the way that she's grown, because like she went to college and stuff, and she made it out perfect, so I want to grow up like that. I don't know, like ever since I met her, I just love school.
He's the only one that listens to me when I speak. I think it's special because I don't tell nobody else about that stuff but Javon. He's like family to me.